that bought his foals and brought here reared. Claire looks after them here for 2 years, 2.5 years, 3 years until they're broken. 90% of them bought his foals and reared, fed every day. So once you buy them and you spend a good few quid in a foal, you have to treat them all as a potential champion. There, you give them everything that's needed in the line of vitamins and feed, and you make sure that their stomach is able to take the feed when pressure is put on them, that they can't eat enough. That's why when you put the gun to their head early, you can get them going, because you know what you have in them, you have the stuff put into them. And then we school them here, loose school them and get them going. They're all in groups in loose sheds of fives and sixes. There's foals, yearlings, two-year-olds, three-year-olds here. Be a crop of sort of 10 or 11 in each group, and hopefully they go on. Some of them be raised point to point and sold, more of them be sold to stores. So top of the range national hunt stock that are top pedigrees, top red stock. So hopefully some of them will go all the way, put it up at lights. That's our set up with them. We feed them well and work them hard, and hopefully some of them will come out on top. Hopefully buy them right. We can buy the goods at the beginning. If you don't have the goods coming in, you won't have the goods going out, but you just have to. You never know which one is going to be the one, you just have a bunch, and it's a numbers game to a degree. Like, you just work away in that and mind them and keep them healthy and work away in them until they're ready to go. You wouldn't be building muscle on them until they're rare, until they're being broken. Like, but you'd be developing bone and making sure they're able to, that they're covered in their bone. You don't need them too heavy either, you just need them hard, and the bone is a big thing. Like, give them calcium, give them copper, we give them seaweed, give them cod liver oil. All the vitamins that any human will be taking, if you give it to anything else, they'll be developing. The bone is the big thing with the young ones. You get the bone up. You let them know who's boss, but you don't play guard them, and you just keep their nature right. That you get, like, there's very few horses here now that you couldn't go out and catch in the field and bring back in, because you're handling them the whole time. They know you, they know the story. They're not going to get black guarded. If they need a skill, they get a skill. When they don't need one, they don't get one, and they just. You respect them, they respect you. You get hard weather, grand, keep them, we give them a good lot of garlic now, starting off, just to keep the, if they have any old flus, keep it off and keep them vaccinated and keep them dosed and keep them top of it. Like. No, you know what, we wouldn't have that much movement. Once you buy them and you get a group in healthy, there wouldn't be any movement in between then until they go again, you know, so you wouldn't have a lot of traffic in and out, you know. Like, we're actually very lucky with King's Theatre, so we've a lot of them, and he's champion sire now, and they're well-bred horses. I mean, you had to pay for them, but you will get paid for them again when they do the business. But you have to stay fashionable and stay, like, you have to look at the sire, the dam, pedigree, confirmation. You take your chance then. If they have the engine, that'll do.
Hold the reins with him. Come on. Right. Hold on. Handy now. Handy.